Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. This is Karuna teaching the course Digital Signal Processing. In this video, we are concentrating on DSP processors part 4. Let us see the TMS320C50 DSP architecture. Before going to discuss about the architecture of the DSP processor, see the features of this TMS320C50 DSP processor. Okay, this is the number of the DSP processor, TMS320C50. Texas Instruments developed this DSP processor named as TMS320C5X. Okay, X may vary 0, 1, 2, 3, 6 and so on. In this topic, we are discussing about C50. It was fabricated with CMOS IC technology. It is a fixed point processor and performs operation on 16-bit data, and operating frequency of this processor is 40 MHz. Single instruction execution time is 50 nanoseconds. Its architectural design is based on the combination of advanced hardware architecture, on-chip peripherals and on-chip memory. It has a highly specialized instruction set and also cost-effective. These features enable the operational flexibility and the device speed. On-chip memory includes 10K words of the RAM and 2K words of the ROM. Let us see the architecture of the TMS320C50. Okay, this is the architecture of the TMS320C50, which divided into 4 blocks. First one is bus structure. See, here data bus and program bus. Next, central processing unit. This is the central processing unit. All of you concentrate on cursor. Again, which is having sub-blocks, parallel logic unit, central arithmetic logic unit, memory mapped registers, auxiliary register arithmetic unit, program controller, counter, status registers, hardware stack, generation of logic, instruction register, and on-chip memory. So, this is the on-chip memory. C50 having program ROM is 2K. So likewise, the C51 processor, C52, C53. I told you, no, X place lo meeru 0, 1, 2, 3, 6. Even ni pet coach, different DSP processors are there. So these processors are varied based on the size of the memory. So C50 having 2K program ROM, and 51 processor having 8K. 5 to 4K, 5 3 16K likewise. Okay, so data or program memory, single axis RAM. This is dual axis RAM. And this dual axis memory showing bank 0, bank 1, bank 2. Okay, likewise, memory sizes are varied according to the architecture number varied. Next, on-chip peripherals. These are all built on processor chip. Okay, so what are the on-chip peripherals? Serial port, TDM port, buffered serial port, timer, so host process port interface, etc. Okay, these are the blocks present on the TMS320C50 architecture. Okay, let us see one by one. First, bus structure. This bus consists of program as well as data bus, which maximize the processing power and provide a high degree of parallelism. This structure consists of 4 buses: program bus, program read bus, data read address bus. Program bus carries the instruction code and immediate operands from program memory to the CPU. Program address bus provides address to program memory space for both read and write operation. Okay, ikkada only read or bus mentioned chesaru kani program address bus is there. Okay, which is used to perform read and write operation. The data read bus, third one, interconnects various elements of the CPU to data memory space. Next, the data read address bus provides the address to access the data memory space. This is about bus structure. Next, so B, central processing unit, which consists, already we have seen, or different units are there in central processing unit. Those are central arithmetic logic unit, parallel logic unit, auxiliary register arithmetic unit, memory mapped registers, program controller. Coming to the first one, central arithmetic logic unit. So let us discuss these five sub blocks of the central processing unit. First one, central arithmetic logic unit, which can perform two's complement arithmetic operation also, which consists parallel multiplier, accumulator, accumulator buffer, product register, shifters, arithmetic logic unit. Let us see the functions of each device. This is the central arithmetic logic unit, parallel multiplier, which can be used to perform multiplication operations on 32-bit signed and unsigned op. All multiply instructions except multiply unsigned instruction performed a signed multiply operation in the multiplier. One of the operand to the multiplier is from the 16-bit temporary register 0, and the second input is from the program bus or data bus. Okay, coming to the product register, which holds the product after performing the multiplication. Next, ALU, which can perform operation on 32-bit data along with the 16-bit accumulator, which carries arithmetic and logical operations, executing most of them in one machine cycle. Here, accumulator provides one of the inputs to the ALU, whereas the product register, accumulator buffer or scaling shifter output provides the second input. So, second input is may come from product register, accumulation buffer, scaling shifter. Okay. So, after performing any operation, the result of the operation in ALU are stored in accumulator. So, the scaling shifter has a 16-bit input connected to the data bus and 32-bit output connected to the ALU. Okay. So, scaling shifters produce a left shift of 0 to 16 bits on the input data. So, 5-bit register, this is the temporary register 1, specifies the number of bits by which the scaling shifter should shift, or shift count is specified by a constant embedded in the instruction word. Okay, so, e register lo manam how many times we have to shift the number. Okay, number is specified in this register for performing scaling operation. Okay, next, coming to the parallel logic unit, which is another logic unit that executes logic operations on data without affecting the content of the accumulator. The multiplier bit in a status or control register or any other memory location can be directly set or clear, test or toggle by the parallel logic unit. After executing the logical operation, parallel logic unit writes the result of the operation to the same memory location from which the first operand was fetched. Next, coming to the auxiliary register arithmetic unit, which consists of a register file containing 8 auxiliary registers. Those are AR0 to AR7. Each register length is 16 bit. There is a register, auxiliary register pointer. The size of that is 3 bit register. And unsigned 16 bit ALU. The auxiliary register file is connected to the auxiliary register arithmetic unit. This auxiliary register arithmetic unit consists auxiliary register, index register, auxiliary register, compare register, block move address register. Okay. So, these auxiliary registers are 16-bit register, can be accessed by the central arithmetic logic unit and modified by the auxiliary register arithmetic unit or PLU. The primary function of auxiliary register is to provide 16-bit address for indirect addressing to data space or for temporary data storage. These registers can also be used as general purpose registers or counters. The contents of auxiliary registers can be stored in the data memory or used as inputs to the central arithmetic logic unit. Next, coming to the index register, like microprocessor lo manam SIDA, we have studied about SI and DI kada. So, the index register is a 16-bit register used by the auxiliary register arithmetic unit as a step value to modify the address in AR auxiliary registers during indirect addressing. The index register value can be added or subtracted from the current AR or any AR update cycle. This can be used to increment or decrement the address in steps larger than 1. Next, this unit contains auxiliary register, compare register. This is used for performing the comparison operation. After performing the comparison, the result is placed in the TC bit of the status flag register, test or control flag bit, TC bit of the status flag register. So block move address register, which is a 16-bit register used to hold the address value of a source destination space of the block move. Can also be used to hold the address value of an operand in program memory for a multiply accumulate operation. Next, memory mapped registers. C5X, X may varies, has 96 registers mapped into page 0 of the data memory space. Konni processors lo memory anedi divided into pages, page 0, page 1, page 2, like that. Okay, that's what here page 0 is mentioned, and some part of the memory space. This memory mapped register space contains various controls and status registers, including those for CPU, serial port, timer, and software wait generators. Additionally, the first 16 IO port locations are mapped into this data memory space, allowing them to be accessed either as data memory using single word instruction or as IO locations with two word instruction. This memory mapped register section contains instruction register, interrupt register, status register. Meeku ivanni telusu side headings gurtu pettukunte meer raayagalaru. Koncham words anevi different ga untayi processor ki, normal conventional processor ki, DSP processor ki. ఎక్స్ట్రా కొన్ని రిజిస్టర్స్ మెమరీస్ పోర్ట్స్ యాడ్ అవుతాయి బికాస్ దిస్ ఇస్ ఎ ఆన్ చిప్ పెరిఫెరల్స్ కాబట్టి సో ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్ రిజిస్టర్ హోల్డ్స్ ద అప్కోడ్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్ బీయింగ్ ఎగ్జిక్యూటెడ్ ఇంటరప్ట్ రిజిస్టర్ ఓకే ఇంటరప్ట్ మాస్క్ రిజిస్టర్ ఇంటరప్ట్ ఫ్లాగ్ రిజిస్టర్ దీస్ ఆర్ 16-bit రిజిస్టర్స్ ఐఎంఆర్ రిజిస్టర్ ఇండివిజువల్లీ మాస్క్ స్పెసిఫిక్ ఇంటరప్ట్స్ ఎట్ రిక్వైర్డ్ టైమ్ ఇంటరప్ట్ ఫ్లాగ్ రిజిస్టర్ ఇండికేట్స్ ద current status of the interrupts, okay, whether interrupt is present or not. Status registers, after executing any operation, the status of that result can be observed from this status register. Two, 16-bit status registers, which contain status as well as control bits for the CPU. Okay, control bits are set by the user, status bits are set by the processor. Okay. So next, coming to the program controller, which contains logic circuitry that decodes the operational instructions, manage the CPU pipeline, store the status of the CPU operation and decodes the conditional operation, which consists the following elements. Okay, so program counter, meeku telusu, stores the address of the next instruction. Status and control registers. C5X has four status and control registers. They are circular buffer control register, process mode status registers ST0 and ST1. Hardware stack. Stack me tells you before going to jump from main program to subprogram, the return address and status of the previous program execution stored onto the stack before going to jump to any subroutine. Okay, after performing subroutine, processor control will return to the main program by retrieving whatever the saved data from the stack. Likewise, the stack is used. Program memory addresses generation. It contains the code. Program antene meeku code kada. So, set of instructions. Okay, so it contains code. And also it stores immediate operands. Okay, immediate operands and data in the microprocessor lo data memory lo save avutundi kani ikkada immediate operands program memory lo save avutundi gurtu pettukondi. Instruction register, 16-bit instruction register hold the opcode of the instruction being executed. These are the parts of the central processing unit. Next, coming to some flags existed in the processor. Two types of status registers, ST0 and ST1. This figure A shows the ST0, figure B shows the ST1. 0 to 8 bits assigned for data memory page register. 9th bit is assigned to interrupt mode flag. Okay, 12th bit is assigned to overflow flag. Likewise, flags are assigned to different bits. Let us see one by one. This is the status flag 0. Okay, about status flag 0, ARP, auxiliary register pointer. These bits select the auxiliary register to be used in indirect addressing. Overflow flag. This bit indicates an arithmetic operation overflow in the ALU. overflow mode, OVM. This bit enables or disables the accumulated overflow saturation mode in the ALU. Next, this is always one, 10th bit. 9th bit, INTM, interrupt mode. This bit globally masks or enables all interrupts. This flag bit has no effect on the non-maskable interrupts. Next, DP, data memory page register. These bits specify the address of the current data memory page. Okay. Likewise, the flag bits of the status register 0 represented. Okay, next, coming to the status flag register 1. ARB, auxiliary register buffer. This is a 3-bit field which holds the previous value contained in ARP in status flag 0 register. And the CNF, 12th bit here, all of you observe. CNF, on-chip RAM configuration control bit. 12th bit is assigned to CNF. This bit is 1 that indicates the on-chip dual access RAM block 0 to be addressable in data memory space or programmable memory space. TC, test or control flag bit. This 1-bit flag stores the result of the ALU or parallel logic unit test bit operations. The status of the test control bit determines if the conditional branch call and return instructions are to be executed. Next, XXM, sign extension mode bit, 10th bit. So this bit field enables or disables the sign extension of an arithmetic operation. C, carry bit. This field indicates whether the CPU stops or continues execution when acknowledging an active hold signal. Next, coming to XF, 5th bit is always 1. XF, this bit field determines the level of the external flag output pin. Next, 2 to 3, 2 bits are always 1-1. 0 to 1, PM, product shift mode bits. These 2 bit fields determine the product shifter mode. So, these are about the flag bits present in status flag register 0, status flag register 1. Next, D, on-chip memory. Already we have seen in block diagram, the structure, C5X structure has a total memory address range of 220K words into 16 bits. The memory space is divided into 4 memory segments. 64K word program memory space, it contains the instruction to be executed. 16K word local data memory space, which stores the data used by the instruction. 64K word input or output ports, it interfaces to external memory mapped peripherals. 32K word global data memory space, it can share data with other peripherals within the system. Ikkada it interfaces to external memory mapped peripherals. Peripherals anniti kuda address lu untai kada, aa address lanni kuda 64K word input or output port memory loni save avutai. Okay, so some part of the memory must be assigned to peripherals to store the peripherals address. Okay, within the system. So, the large on-chip memory of C5X includes program read-only memory, data or program single access, RAM, SARAM and single, DARAM and dual access. Okay, good to put it. So, these are the different parts existed on memory, on processor chip. Next, coming to the on-chip peripherals. Already we have discussed about on-chip peripherals in previous class. What are the peripherals presented on the processor chip? TMS320C50, clock generator, hardware timer, software programmable wait state generator, general purpose I/O pins, parallel I/O port, serial port interface, buffered serial port, TDM serial port, host port interface, user maskable interrupts. Let us see one by one. Clock generator, which consists of an internal oscillator and phase lock loop circuit, which can be driven internally by a crystal oscillator or driven externally by a clock source. Hardware timer, which is a 4-bit prescalar clocks at a rate that is between 1 by 2 and 1 by 32 of the machine cycle rate, depending upon the timer's divided down ratio. So, it acts as a down counter, producing interrupts to CPU at regular intervals. The timer can be stopped or restarted, reset or disabled by specific status bits, which consist of three registers. Those are timer counter register, timer period register, timer control register. Timer counter register gives the current count of the timer. Timer period register defines the period for the timer. Timer control register controls the operations of the timer. Next, software programmable wait state generators can be interfaced without any external hardware with slower off-chip memory and I/O devices. This feature consists of multiple wait state generating circuits. Each circuit is user programmable to operate in different wait states for off-chip memory accesses. Wait states kavalante, we have to enable this generator. General purpose I/O pins, namely branch control input pin and external flag output pin, that are controlled by software. Like a branch control input keeps track of the status of external devices and executes conditional branches depending upon the requirement. External flag output communicates with external devices through software by setting or resetting the pin with the help of this instruction, set CXF clear CXF. Meeru block diagram observe cheyandi. What are the peripherals present on the processor chip? Coming to the parallel IO, there is a total of 64 parallel IO ports, of which 16 are memory mapped in data memory space. All the IO ports can be addressed through the instructions in and out or through data memory to perform read and write operations. There is a signal IS which differentiates accessing of memory mapped IO space to that of program and data space. Interfacing with external IO devices can be done through the IO ports with the minimal off-chip address decoding circuit. Serial port interface. Three different kinds of serial ports are available. General purpose serial port, time division multiplexed serial port and buffered serial port. Each processor contains at least one general purpose high speed synchronous full duplexed serial port interface. Serial port is capable of operating at up to 1/4 the machine cycle rate. Serial port control register, data receive register, the data transmit receiver, data transmit shifter register, and the data receive shift register control and operate the serial port interface. Okay, these are the different types of registers present in the serial port interface. Let us see one by one. Serial port control register contains the mode control and status bits of the serial port. Data receive register holds the incoming serial data. Data transmit shift register controls the shifting of the data from data transmit register to output pin. Data receive shift register controls the storing of the data from the input pin to the data receive register. Ikkada shift register enduku general ga processor having parallel lines, parallel bus system. So if you want to perform serial interface, serial communication, then you have to use the serial port interface. Processor is having bus system. That bus consists of data bus, address bus. Okay, data bus carries data bits parallelly. Those are to be converted into or shifted to serial fashion. That's what here, data transmit shift register, data receive shift register. Parallel data to be converted into serial data with the help of shift register. Okay, that's what these registers named as, transmit shift register, receive shift register. DC process can also be used to perform serial communication over long distances also. Okay, next, buffered serial port available on C56 and C57 devices. X place lo ikkada 6-7 pettandi. It is a full duplexed double buffer serial port and an auto buffering unit. Okay, this buffered serial port provides flexibility on the data stream length. Next, TDM serial port, which is used in case of time division multiplexing. Host port interface available on C57S and LC57. It is a 8-bit parallel IO port that provides an interface to a host processor. Information can be exchanged between the DSP and the host processor through on-chip memory that is accessible to both the host processor and the C57. Next, coming to the interrupts occurred internally or externally. So there are 4 external interrupt lines, INT1 to INT4, and 5 internal interrupts. A timer interrupt and 4 serial port interrupts are user maskable. When interrupt service routine is executed, the contents of the program counter are saved on an 8-level hardware stack, and the contents of 11 specific CPU registers are saved in one deep stack. The request based on interrupt control will jump from main program to sub program, means ISR routine. Sub program nothing but interrupt service routine. Okay, before jump to that routine, processor needs to store all the status of the previous executed program on stack. Okay, so when a return from interrupt instruction is executed, the CPU contents registers are restored. Ikkada cut ayindi chudandi. Let us see various interrupt types supported by TMS320C5X processor. So these are the interrupts present in C5X processor. Ikkada meeku okka description undi, all of you go through this descriptions. RS external reset signal, INT1 external interrupt line 1 2 3. Okay, INT, this is related to internal timer interrupt, okay, like that, NMI, non-maskable interrupt. These interrupts having different priorities. So, first highest priority goes to external reset signal, RS. Okay, next, INT2 having fourth priority, like that. Corresponding ISRs to these interrupts are stored in memory locations. Those are started at different addresses. Okay, those are mentioned in hexa as well as in decimal. So we can say location of the interrupt. Okay, likewise, interrupts are present in TMS320C5X. So this is about architecture of TMS320C5X. Meeku ee topic lo 3-4 questions raise avachu. Anta okay sir adigaru. Okay, so idokati prepare aithe you can answer to 3 or 4 questions. Okay, individual ga adutaru, what are the on chip peripherals, write about interrupt structure of the TMS320C5X, and write about central processing unit. Ilaga meeku different questions may be raised from this topic. So theory kabatti oka 2-3 times read cheyandi, endukante ivanni kuda terminology new ga untundi than conventional microprocessor. Meeku microprocessor architecture idea undi kabatti you can explain easily by reading twice or thrice. With this topic 15 it is over. Okay, thank you, we will meet in next topic.